Assalamualaikum viewers, welcome to Academia Coaches. Today I am going to discuss the topic of transcription. Transcription is the first step in gene expression. The transcription is the process in which particular segment of DNA, this is the structure of DNA, and this is nucleotide base sequence of DNA, okay. The transcription is a process in which the particular segment of DNA is transcribed into RNA. This is known as RNA. And this process is carried out by the enzyme RNA polymerase. Okay viewers, now I am going to repeat the definition of transcription. Transcription is the first step in gene expression in which the particular segment of DNA is transcribed into the RNA by the help of enzyme RNA polymerase. And it results in the formation of antiparallel RNA strand. As you can see in this example that the strand of RNA is antiparallel to the strand of DNA, which is known as primary transcript. The nucleus of eukaryotes have three RNA polymerases. RNA polymerase 1. The RNA polymerase 1 located in the nucleolus. And in the nucleolus, it transcribes ribosomal RNA. That's include 18S ribosomal RNA, 28S ribosomal RNA, and 5.8S ribosomal RNA. The second type of RNA polymerases are RNA polymerase 2. RNA polymerase 2 present in the nucleoplasm and transcribe the messenger RNA. The third type of RNA polymerases are RNA polymerase 3. And RNA polymerase 3 transcribe the genes for transfer RNA. That includes 5S ribosomal RNA, 7S RNA, and other associated specialized RNAs. The process of transcription can be divided into three steps, that is initiation, elongation, and termination of transcription. Now first I will discuss about the initiation. The initiation of RNA by RNA polymerases is directed by promoter regions. And these promoter regions are present to the 5 prime of transcription start site. The initiation of RNA by RNA polymerases is detected by this promoter region. And this region is present towards 5 prime of the transcription start site. The RNA transcribes one strand of DNA template, that is antisense sense strands. One strand of DNA, and it transcribes in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. During the process of initiation, RNA polymerases recognize the promoter region and unwind the DNA. RNA polymerase recognize promoter region and unwind DNA. The promoter site of RNA This is the promoter site. Promoter site of RNA polymerase 1-2 is highly conserved sequence. RNA polymerase 2 conserved sequence located about 25 to 35 base pair upstream. 25 to 35 base pair upstream. 8 minus 30 base. And is known as TATA sequence. The start site is known as plus 1 transcriptional site. And the TATA box position is 8 minus 25. The sequence which is present around the TATA box, this sequence which is present around the TATA box is also very important because it affects the efficiency of initiation. And the transcription also regulated by upstream sequence that lies to 5 prime to the TATA box. And this sequence is known as upstream sequence. The upstream sequence is enriched with guanine and cytosine and known as GC box. In order to initiate the process of transcription, RNA polymerase 2 also require several other proteins or protein complexes. And these protein complexes are known as general or basal transcriptional factors. With the help of these protein factors, the RNA polymerase bind and start the process of transcription. And these proteins called TF2, which are known as transcription factor for RNA polymerase 2. The first step in initiation is binding of TF2D. The first step is binding of TF2D to the TATA box. And TF2D binds to the TATA box with the help of transcription binding protein, TBP, that is transcription binding protein. After the binding of TF2D, the TF2A is bind to the TF2D. And TF2A stabilizes the binding of TF2D. After binding of TF2A, the next protein complex is TF2B, which bind to the TF2D TATA box, and it also bind to the RNA polymerase 2. After TF2B, the TF2E and TF2F is bind. After TF2E, the TF2F and TF2H is bind, which is followed by TF2E. This all complex contain 40 polypeptide and it is called the transcriptional initiation complex. Okay viewers, because the transcription and this all is very complex process, therefore I am repeating it, that the process initiation of the RNA by RNA polymerase is directed by the promoter region. And promoter site for RNA polymerase is highly conserved sequence, which is located about 25 to 35 base pair upstream. And this sequence is called the TATA sequence or TATA box. The start site is called the plus 1, that is transcriptional start site. And some sequences which are present around the TATA box are also very important because it affects the efficiency of initiation. Transcription also regulated by the upstream sequences which are present towards the 5 prime to TATA box. For the initiation of transcription, the RNA polymerases also require some protein complexes which are known as TF2, that means transcriptional factor for RNA polymerase 2. First, the binding of transcriptional factor to D which is binded by the transcriptional binding protein DBB. After this complex, the next process is the binding of TF2A protein, which stabilizes the binding of TF2D. After the TF2A, the TF2B is bind, which can bind with the Tata box and also can bind with the RNA polymerase too. So it acts as bridging. RNA polymerase, which already complex with TF2F, is now binds, which is followed by the TF2E and TF2H. And this all protein complex, which is bind with the RNA polymerase, consists of 4T polypeptide, and it is known as transcriptional initiation complex. Okay, after T initiation, the next step of transcription is known as elongation. The TF2H, transcriptional factor 2H protein, it has two functions. Because it is an helicase, it uses ATP to unwind the DNA helix. First, it uses ATP. This is the double helical structure of DNA, 5 prime to 3 prime and 3 prime to 5 prime. The TF2H helicase uses ATP to unwind DNA and start transcription. And the second function is its phosphorylate RNA polymerase 2. This is the structure of RNA polymerase, and its phosphorylate the RNA polymerase 2. It phosphorylates the RNA polymerase 2, which causes the enzyme to change its conformation and dissociate from other proteins. The phosphorylation occurs at C terminal. This is the C terminal. C terminal domain, which is known as CTD of RNA polymerase 2. Now the RNA polymerase 2 start moving along the strand of DNA template. And synthesize the RNA. Okay, now I am going to repeat the process of elongation. In elongation, the TF2H protein have two main functions. First, it uses the ATP to unwind the DNA, and then it phosphorylates the C terminal domain of the RNA polymerase 2, and then the RNA polymerase 2 start moving along the DNA template and synthesize the RNA. The RNA molecule, which is made by protein coating gene, is known as primary transcript. The last step of transcription is the termination of transcription process. The elongation of RNA chain continues until termination occurs. The RNA polymerase 2 do not stop transcription at specific site. It stops at various distance downstream of a gene. RNA genes that are transcribed by RNA polymerase lack any specific signal or sequence that terminate the RNA polymerase 2. The transcript is cleaved at internal position before the RNA polymerase finish transcribing the gene. And this serves as RNA template or pre-messenger RNA. Cleavage site considered end of the gene, and transcription is ended by 5' exonucleases. The 5' exonucleases digest all overhanging RNA, and RNA polymerase disengage from DNA. RNA polymerase 2 disengage from DNA, and termination take place, and transcription is terminated. My today lecture was about the topic of transcription, which is divided into three stages, that is initiation, elongation, and termination. In my next lecture, I will describe about the post-transcriptional modifications. Thank you so much, viewers, and Allah Hafiz.
Do not forget to subscribe my channel for latest and more relevant videos. Thank you.